I don't know. I love the snow. Well, I love New York.
I've been there.
New York, too cold.
You are divorced. Sad.
Sad. Last winter we skied down Fifth Avenue. It was lovely. Come to my room tomorrow morning. Come at 8, after my walk. I will give you my interview.
8 is so early. After your walk.
Okay.
What's your room number?
No, but crocs, yes.
So my baby alligator's really a crocodile?
Don't snort with lightness.
How would you like to begin?
The man in the bandages.
You want to start with him?
No, but you do.
Always be submissive and polite. Treat him like a king. His dagger is sharp.
His dagger is sharp. Who are we talking about?
The man at the bar, in the bandages.
The next time you see him, take a look at his ring. That is all that matters. You'll never see a diamond like it in your life, Master.
Well, what happened to his face?
Drums and dancing in the dark.
Okay.
No electricity.
Okay.
When the moon was out, I wouldn't sleep. My mother used to hide under the bed during the Santeria ceremonies. They would come. I would hide too. But listen, they were very big men. Oh, then the festivals, the comparisons. I used to sneak out with my hand, broken bottles, joyful dancing. My father could not stop me. Then a neighbor bought me white shoes. Neighbors used to come to hear me sing the little ones to sleep. Everyone knew I was born to be a singer and that I would die standing up on stage, as my grandmother famously said. I've forgotten the question. I've told this story a thousand times.
A thousand times? To other journalists?
I am well known throughout Latin America.
She is a star. She is the queen,
ma'am. Oh, just think how lucky you are, Mary. So, to keep this interesting for me, I will ask you a question every time you ask me one. That's fair.
No, not really.
How did you get into your business? What made you want to do it? I don't think Felipe will allow any recording, Mary. Playing cards? What else do you have in your bag? The little alligator?
Okay. All right. What made me want to do this, be a journalist? Corruption. Political corruption. Corrupt politicians. This may sound naive, but when I was young, I read about a girl, Claire Bonnet. She dressed in men's clothing and joined a pirate crew. Maybe that's what attracts me to writing about corruption. It's exciting.
Fascinating, Mary. Oh, not what you say about politics. Politics is boring. But what makes you, you? That is fascinating. Mary, pirate girl, I like you. But you must tell me, what's wrong with corruption? It's just business.
Yes.
Okay, your next question of me is, what technique or style do I use to make me a singer?
What? What's the question?
What techniques do you use?
Oh, what techniques do I use? Oh, well, follow the money, that's one main technique. And persistence.
Not a technique.
Oh, and journalism it is. Following the money is how you find out what's going on in politics. It's a roadmap. But then you really have to keep working and follow through and not give in.
Boring, Mary. Music is much more interesting. Cuban music. We have a thousand kinds.
Almost.
Okay. Who do you really write about? Clearly not entertainers like me. I know. You write about bad guys.
Sure, sure I do.
Sure you do.
Yeah.
Sure, see?
Yeah, see?
You're trying to put the sting on me and my boys.
You think you're so smart? We think this is a setup.
You kidding? Are you being funny?
We ain't funny, you funny.
Hilarious. You're gonna end up looking like Swiss cheese, full of holes.
Rat stink.
That's what got you into this? Writing about bad guys?
Yeah, that's what got me into this. I got a press pass.
Girl pirate with a press pass.
Pirate with a press pass.
I sat in the same booth Joey Gallo sat in when he got his in the clam bar in my neighborhood. You guys ever been so close to a kingpin?
They owe you any favors?
Who? This is getting off track.
I know a kingpin owes me a favor because I gave him a pack of cigarettes. Okay, real talk now, Miss Mary. The man downstairs is wanting to give you a dance lesson.
I know, he's not giving me a dance lesson.
Yeah, if you meet with him, be sure it is in a bright location in the daylight. This is my advice to you. Always be submissive and polite. Do not challenge him. If you meet him in the dark, remember, he has a dagger, and he can move like a king.
Okay, Felipe, I think we've scared Marion.
I ain't scared this punk.
This is our suite, so watch yourself, Americano.
Is it your hotel, is it?
Sure.
Who says?
I say.
You better watch yourself, Buster. You're going to end up in the Creeps joint.
Creeps joint? There's no such thing.
Oh, that's enough, you two. Dios mio, we may need a drink.
A drink at 8 in the morning? Mm. Oh, you must watch a lot of George Braff movies, or are you gangsters?
We are entertainers, my dear. You saw the show. Ask me your questions, you will see. Anyway, you have a tennis lesson at 11.
I have a tennis lesson at 11? No. I have a tennis lesson at 10.
No, you have one at 11. We changed it. This interview is going to take twice as long as you think. There are a lot of things I want to know. What is it like to ski down Fifth Avenue? What is Bud Powell doing? Who's staying at the Lenox Hotel in Ballet and Lincoln Center? And we want to know about Dizzy Gillespie, right, Nestor?
Right.
And your monk Thelonious and Bing Crosby.
No, I'm not Bing Crosby.
I always have a deck of cards. Rummy. Best way to get an interview without stress. Another little technique I use. And I have a feeling this is probably going to be a very long, drawn-out interview.
Okay, we can talk like girls now, right? You know, you have my number. Every time I pull a card, you come up with the same one.
Not every time.
Don't push me.
I can't help it. I'm fidgety. Oh, 3 7s, 4 jacks. Another round.
More about me?
Okay.
The mulattas were a great bunch of women. Ah, wonderful dancers. So beautiful. They would flow out onto the stage after me one by one in their plumed hair. When El Diablo came to power, they all left or retired.
El Diablo? You mean...
Yes, that's exactly who I mean. When the devil came to power, the mulattas all left or retired. Too bad. Very sad. The world was a better place when they were performing in Cuba.
What year was it that you joined in Milan?
1951. I remember clear as day. Was so happy when a producer invited me to sing with them. I went to Mass the Sunday after I got the call and prayed. I did the rosary for my family. It was the beginning of my great career.
How long have you been gone from Cuba?
My family had 2 rooms when I was a child. We had nothing. We were happy, but cramped. Still, what I miss most besides my family is Cuba's beautiful palms. Oh, how they give form to the breeze. Can you see it? I miss my brother, my mother.
I know you don't care about Batista, the man before El Diablo.
But I thought he was the greatest president. I didn't care that he had 10,000 slot machines or that his brother got all the parking meters. So I got a little extra. What I saw was our music going out to all of Latin America. Radio stations were flourishing. Stages were lit and decorated. Nightclubs with magnificent crystal palms and colored lights. It's still that way in Caracas and Bogota, but no longer in Cuba. My mother, my two younger sisters, and my brother here. You, Mary, you see men in dark suits. You see them with their hands in their pockets. You look for secret bank accounts. And I see a stage, lights, fine piano, crystal chandelier. People enjoying themselves, even in the barrios. People could forget about money. They didn't have to worry about fighting at home. Now, I work hard, then I rest, read magazines, get my hair done, buy a new wig, call my dressmaker. Live and let live, Mary. These people you write about, they're just men who grow old. You know, we cannot choose our faults.
Okay.
Got it. And you?
Your turn. Narcotics, prostitution, extortion, burglary, theft, child pornography, criminal enterprises, often in collusion with government. I can keep going.
Mary, you see this piano? It has 88 keys, yes? Black keys and white keys. Listen to this.
Mexico is like the moon. Cozumel Island is a part of Mexico, right? Not a damn thing here, I mean, except for bugs.
Alligators.
No, crocodiles. Alligators are in southern Florida. Where's our guy? I mean, our friend, you know.
She knows the man I'm looking for. Ah, so you admit you're looking for him?
Forget it, what she does. I gotta have a nap, a shower. Is there hot water in this place? I like the pool area, real nice chairs. I'm gonna have a relax down there later for sure. And the drinks in this place are cheap. I hit a dark and stormy just now. I could be drunk for the next 2 days. Mary, who are these people? They know our guy? Good job, Mary. Way to follow up. Aren't you going to introduce us? They know the guy in the bandages.
The man you refer to, our close friend. Very nice man. Maybe you will see him again. Introductions are in order.
I got that in the gift shop. I don't want to have him get a heart attack or something.
We'll talk later, David.
Oh, Mary. I have terrible news.
What?
It's worse than the other bomb.
What? What is it? Tell me. David!
I can't tell you, Mary. I'm too tired. I gotta have a nap, shower, the other way around. There's hot water in this place.
David, you can't not tell me.
I'm afraid to tell you, Mary. I'm surprised you don't know. It's about the primaries. Oh, Mary. I'm glad she has a friend here.
Well, Mary gets into trouble, so she needs friends.
Yes, she's always in trouble.
David, after your nap, if you're not in my room, come here. Wait, oh, both room numbers. Jeez,
rude man.
What does he have to tell me? What's the bad news? I'm really worried.
You're not worried, boy. We don't worry. We are blessed. I like you. This has been a good interview, and there's more to come.
That's it.
I still have a question, though. Oh, actually, a few questions. What is the name of your husband and children? Where are they? I wanted to be a mother and a housewife, too.
Oh, I'm not a housewife. How awful. You mean my ex-husband, Thomas. He has our three children with him at his country house. Used to be mine, too. Crappy lawyer. Thomas always takes the children in the summer. They're not safe with me in New York right now. We were getting calls, threatening calls. We knew it was a mob. My son Andrew said that a man called and asked him what time he walks the dog. And I told him to hang up immediately if that man ever called again.
Oh, dear Sam.
But I got worried. Not really worried.
You don't worry?
No. My name is Mary. I've been told they might kidnap my children. They might name them. But that they would never touch a hair on the head of a woman named Mary.
California.
Night before last, just a few hours ago. Oh my God.
Take heart, Mary. There's scoop already about another shooter. I heard Dan talking about it earlier. Not sure if he got it. It's not a done deal. It wasn't just the Arab, other guys. Something about a lady in a polka dot dress. We'll get to the bottom of this. They won't do it again, lying bastards. We'll get out the bloodhounds.
Well, how about a drink? Here we are in Cousin Man. It's a divorce vacation, and you are my guests. Let's get comfortable. Lucky boy, coming to Mexico and finding us? No rowdy cowboys or Arabs here. Just sophisticated ladies and poor boys. A way to rest, drink dark and stormy, and grow some hair on that little chest of yours.
Great.
You know this boy, Long? Boy with the flat chest?
Rina,
you know this boy, Long?
Oh, boy with a flat chest. Ah, only a few years. No muscle. I think he was in puberty when we met. Did you get so old? My first encounter with him came to me with an idea for a story. Something about corruption and entertainment. Thought I would take that bait.
I had a good lead for a story, but she wasn't interested.
When he first came to me, my boss brought him down to my little office and I had to size him up quick.
I pitched my story. I thought she'd bite, but she looks like a pushover. She's not.
Sounds like a good story, Mary. Did you bite that fish?
No. Actually, I sent him off on a different story. Little excursion downtown. Kicking and screaming.
Uh-huh.
At gay bar in the village. I won't mention which bar, but you know, a couple years ago, the state prohibited alcohol to them.
Why no alcohol?
Oh, homosexuals were considered disorderly, is why they banned liquor.
Oh no, homosexuals.
What is a gay bar in a village?
Hey, you know the Zona Rosa, chica?
Yeah.
And that is your answer.
That's right. A really groovy word, gay. Zona Rosa, like queer.
I don't think she knows what the village is.
Oh, everyone knows the village, don't you?
Of course, I know the village. Why didn't you say so? And gay, it's groovy, like Neil Sedaka.
Working on a groovy thing, hey.
Oh, it's too early for me. Okay. Pina colada.
Oh no, I work tonight.
You work tonight?
Yeah. Well, you won't take no for an answer. Very small drink, same as Mary.
Huh. This is your own. Very nice. Felipe. Oh, it's not polite, Felipe. Well, I'll call for some crushed ice.
She wouldn't take my story. She never does.
That's not true. As I was saying, my editor brought him down to my little office, which I thought was really mean, bringing a skinny know-nothing kid down to me, city editor. So I ripped an article out of the paper, handed it to him, sent him off to the village, and said, "Off you go, come back with a black eye."
Still skinny.
No hair on that little chest.
I thought it was going to be easy. I came back with 2 black eyes and a concussion.
What happened?
Right from the beginning, it was doomed. I said to the bartender, who was obviously queer, but no dummy, nice place he got here. He looked at me hard, guess that was code for you ain't a fag. What's it to you, he said. I was taken aback, but I played dumb, because I needed a story. How the cops were collecting percentage of the place.
Oh, jeez, Neil, the police, be careful.
He asked me a few questions about who I was, and I started to make up something, but then I froze. My intuition was screaming, "You're a sitting duck now." The bartender pressed a button behind the bar, a buzzer. I saw there were 2 buzzers. I'm thinking one buzzer for we got trouble with someone who's not queer, and the other buzzer for we got trouble, copper in the house. No, not yet. Whichever buzzer it was, I heard it going off in the kitchen, and 2 goons came rushing out.
Oh, dirty rats.
Yes, that's right.
We don't fall for any cop suits, one of the queer goons said as he grabbed my shoulder, scratching my ear with his big, fat fingernail. I found my voice. In fact, I screamed, "I'm a homosexual!" I don't know why I said that, because I didn't know that then, and I should have yelled, "I'm not a cop."
You were such a clean-cut young man, caught like toy.
They grabbed my collar, and I tried to stand up, but there was a scuffle. I lost my footing and went over onto the floor. I remember thinking how dirty the floor was, and wouldn't my mom be mad at me about blood on my dress shirt? I call my mom every week. We're very close. They must have thought I was dead or out cold, so they talked about everything. First about me, calling me names like cocksuck, you know, then about the revenge they were going to get.
Revenge?
On the cops who were extorting money. They were just drawn away about what nights they had to pay the extortion money, who the detective was, said his name, who came in which nights, and so on. Like I wasn't even there. So you see, I did get my story.
Yes, you did.
And I got a kick in the side from one of them for no reason at all. I realized they were probably just drunk, and maybe they'd forget about me. But I had my story, names and all.
David, oh, Mary, this great kid is great.
Not a kid, just skinny.
Then the coppers were coming to the joint. Saw me on the floor under the bar, didn't even pick me up. Faggot, one of them said, must have been given a BJ by the looks of where he is. When a queer gets the hots, he kicked me in the other eye. But I could only think of one thing. I had my story. Now, what was the angle?
I don't remember. We published it the same week.
I'm excited for you, David.
That was very serious business. Fingering the police, publishing the precinct that it was in. Well, not a problem legally, but dangerous, you know?
I realized journalism wasn't any fun. I had a terrible headache. Not only do you get beat up, but you have to research and fact check. Doing the article took so much time out of that week that I lost my other job, which was better money. By far.
Oh, I'm sorry. Drink's almost ready.
Maybe you should give them any.
Mary, remember the party at your house where I tripped over the paper bag? Mary has these great parties to get to know people. Interested players, wine and dine sources, VIP, smart women. There were so many writers, politicians, connected Italians from the neighborhood, Irish detectives.
Dirk was there, and Serpico?
Yeah, Serpico. So many people, and the drinks flowing. Mary has these great parties.
Okay.
The apartment was jammed. Coats all keep high in Mary's bed in the middle room. On the floor next to the bed, there was a paper bag and an expensive leather coat folded up next to it. I had been talking with an assemblyman who we thought was on the tape, and I had to go get my pencil and pad for my coat. When I went into the room where the coats were, I tripped over the back, and bang, the revolver went off! There were two guns in there! The assemblyman slipped out to the elevator, slipped out kind of cool. Everyone else stayed put, shocked, and still drunk.
David, when will you learn?
What learn? The guns belonged to a Russian businessman slash mole who was there at the party. Mary, why was the Russian there? Anyway, he told us all to calm down. It was only a small caliber, but I was really steamed and made some comment about how whoever had the guns should be in Rikers or Sing Sing, and that all Russians are crooks. He smiled at me with a huge mouthful of golden black teeth, and I said, and you know I was drunk, you eat a lot of candy in Russia? He said, if you know what's good for you, Sonny, you won't talk about what my mother feeds me. I couldn't shut up, just running my mouth about how I pumped him full of lead and make him squeal about his guns in the paper bag. I actually used the word squeal.
And to send you to jail, sucker's gonna sling to you the whole time.
That's right, man. I'm gonna send him up to Sing Sing, or Rikers, sucker.
I'm gonna pump you full of lead and make you squeal.
And what did you learn, young man?
If your source is running to an elevator, get on it with it.
I was ready to gush and you missed it.
Yeah, but we have a good file on these guys.
And I know where we're going to get more.
Mary has spies everywhere.
So, tell me about this boy, Bobby.
Oh. I just can't believe it. Dr. King in April, now Bobby, his brother 5 years ago. I won't believe it until I see the times. I can't read that, it's in Spanish.
He had just won the California primary.
Yay. What is making you so sad? This man who was killed, his name is Bobby, why do you love him?
Yes, Sylvia, it's terrible. He was going to end the war. He won California. God, he won California. He would have gotten the free delegates of the convention. Damn, Humphrey. Dying-in-the-wool, boring dealmaker.
He looked like a boy, but he was a father with 11 kids.
He was the attorney general under his brother, and a senator, till yesterday. Going to stop the war. And his brother, President Kennedy.
Oh, please, please, do not say his name.
Do not say his name. She knows, the Greenland must know what he did, she not.
Do you mean the former president, JFK?
JFK, Genghis Khan.
Our Camelot, you're Genghis Khan. Why don't you say his name, Sylvia? What are your views?
The man abandoned us, and he was too nice to the world.
Fidel Castro.
Shh. F.C.
You joke! My dear, dear mother is there, in Cuba. This is her in the picture. In the beginning, the worm came to my concerts, sat in the front row with his long, stinky cigars, expecting me to bow and scrape. They would not get anything from me, not even a hello. I will tell you a story. I found out he was coming to my concert. wanted to be seen with a big star in his new communist country. They took everything. A few blocks away from the theater, I asked my driver to stop. I would keep what was mine. You see, when I was young, my family was very poor. But when I became famous, I wore gold coins, bracelets with many gold coins, and earrings and a necklace of jewels. I saw an old woman, a vendor, outside the theater. I said to her, "If I give all these to you, will you keep them safe for me?" Imagine that. I took them off one by one and gave them to her. Later, after the show, I went back, and she returned everything to me.
So you are an exile, then?
We are all wishing to see your beloved Cuba. After every engagement. Felipe, I do not see if so bore me. Your pain is fresh. You have lost your leader. Your war continues. Gordita, I wrap you in my arms and warm you with the breeze of my eyelid. Everything is in my voice. Love, sweet things about the ocean, the waving palms, the dance in your body. Move with me. Be free. Judge you. We will give you a dance lesson before you meet the incognito man.
Incognito man? Heroes. Soon to be President JFK, former President RFK. I say their names with pride. Kennedy, Robert, King, Martin, X, Malcolm, Kennedy, John.
And the millions of Vietnamese killed in your war?
I was 15 when the president was shot. 1963, I was a boy.
Your president had many enemies, and his little brother.
It's been a hell of a decade.
You can say Dr. King's name, and that boy Emmett Till, perhaps, but not your dead presidents. Snakes to our people.
King had just come out against the war like Bobby, and look what happened to them.
The war? Your war. We have our own wars, Mr. David. If the captain allows you to speak with
him. You mean the man in the bandages? He's a captain.
Captain, that is all. Ask him about a war. He will tell you.
You ask him. I have my own questions.
There he is.
Down there by the pool. Yes. With another man. They're both smoking. Do I address him as Captain?
Yes.
Look at him down there. Senor Bandages.
You see him?
Yeah, he's right there. Come look.
I can't move. I'm paralyzed.
Cuts a nice figure.
My kind of guy. Sexy, that bandaged face.
Like making love to a viper.
Seducing. No, not a viper. A panda bear. A gentleman. Mary should meet him. He's cuddly.
Sweet and cuddly.
Yes, Felipe. Yes.
Vampire.
Who says? The guy's very nice. Are you saying he's a killer?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He ain't no killer. Killed soup. Dirty rat.
I admire that he can hide his face. Wish I could hide my face. I could be anyone. Wouldn't have to pretend. Look at me. New York City reporter, working his way up. I've got to be some smart young guy working on his career. Voices in my head say, don't be a bum, be brave, put yourself in harm's way, everyone's getting killed. Be tough, you ought to be, harass and control your sources. Then, sit behind a typewriter half the day. Your fingers, your poor fingers, 70 words a minute, no mistakes, dot your I's, cross your T's.
And spell.
I can't stand it.
Well, whoever interviews the captain...
I have to go to the bathroom.
Well, it certainly should not be you, then. Whoever interviews the captain should learn a few dance steps. Be nice and ladylike.
Well, it's going to be me. I always protect Mary from the creeps. Right, Mary?
As you wish.
I think Felipe is making David upset.
I'm not upset. Nature calls.
Senora?
It would do you good.
Can I just dance with you, Sylvia?
No. There's nothing like dancing with a man.
Oh,
he's still down there next to the pool. I've gotta go.
That is not my lipstick, is it?
I wouldn't use someone else's lipstick without asking. I'm ready to meet the captain.
You had this planned?
Very nice and ladylike. Our men will like that.
Let me help you.
Thank you.
God, you do look nice. Why didn't you tell me?
Do you have your camera? Tape recorder? Okay.
He is a comedian.
He is a very committed journalist.
I am impressed.
Be careful.
We cannot afford to lose another sailor.
He's a skin diver. He can swim as fast as a great white and as effective. Look, he swept his catch to the other line. Tompkins, Pepperfish.
I say, put another wrinkle in the jib, Captain. Slow her down.
I am the captain. I am the captain. The sea queen is like a horse at the gate. Can't slow her. But look at that basket of Tompkins, Pepperfish. Can't you see? Oh, what a fine day. Two large fish. Count them, two.
Donatello grips the other cord. I beg you, haul him out.
Put your hands on another one, Donatello. Strangle it if you have to. Take care, I see them darting in your direction.
Mala jo jatele fama, jatele fama. Te gale cavalaria, te gale cavalaria, te gale cavalaria.
I've been thinking about what you say, and I do not agree. A man is not what I want. I'm not going in that direction. I'm as focused as that spyglass.
You know the advantages. Captain Francis commands a ship. He is a man of wealth and means. He will retire and be governor for sure. And he will have slaves, no matter the law.
All those things are true, but I do not love him, Sylvia. And I'm not looking for that in any case.
Love is rated too high. You do not want these things, but you want to sail the world. This schooner is fast. Think of all the places Captain Francis has seen.
Opium smuggled in the East China Sea. Slaves run to the Spanish Main in the Mexican Gulf. Rum run back across the Atlantic. Oh, the captain has corrals with Tunisians and Italians, hobnobbed with Americans and Chinese. But Sylvia, imagine waking up with him. That scar is a gash on the sunrise. A typhoon in the morning sky.
Mala jo jatele fama, jatele fama.
And Lupita, listen. Upon waking, I wish to see a gentle person. Not an irate crocodile with a wound that never heals. And you. You do not need Felipe de Gascony Ortega. There is more in this world than one man for one woman.
Yes, Felipe de Gascony Ortega is my best lover.
Really? The best? But you don't know how to
try some sails and peel roots your very last days. Huh? You will languish in a small man's kitchen. A small man who is angered when his meal is short.
For 3 years, I have worn men's clothing, and I like that. I can beat my chest like the apes.
Different degrees of servitude. Lucky rich white girl. But your luck and your gold will run out, along with your charm.
But it is my gold now. I have earned it.
Every peso.
My mother is an aristocrat, small-minded. My father is a stamp collector.
They are still wealthy. You told me your father was a French postmaster in Bermuda. You should go back to him.
Even as a young child, I shunned his high position as my father, as I shunned the captain of this schooner. Besides, my mother is the one descended from the Sinus of the Magna Carta. My mother is of the better side. This is what I think of love.
Love is messy, and we cannot choose our fathers. Still, it is good to have another hard, brave woman aboard. It's not anyone who can keep up with pirates and slave runners. You are indeed a strong woman, Mary. That makes three. You, me, and Marcella. As long as we do our little tricks without becoming impregnated, we will be fine. Even the whist Marcella has kept her fresh eggs in the jar.
But with our slave cargo, when the English catch us, we will hang. But mind you, not a woman who is pregnant. Consider that, Sylvie.
Could be. Could be.
There he is! Hard to leave! When you haul him up, do not lose his line, or the line for that fine catch. A basket of conch. Donatello has battled three dangerous pepperfish, and one of flesh I find most pleasing.
The thunder of cannon has ceased.
What say you, the... My hearing is impaired. The cannon has ceased?
We must fly. The man of war hunts slavers like us. She comes from that point of land there.
I have a taste for pepperfish.
Each of us has a stake in our cargo, and you have three slaves to R1. Good ones. Why risk it all for your personal dinner?
They're hauling him out now!
Captain.
Fine catch, Donatello. Now, tell us what you saw the bubble shell. I want Felipe de Gasca de Ortega to hear. Until he hears your story, he will not get underway. The beautiful mermaid, or merman that has been dreaming along as we sail, who do you think she or he rests at night? Donatello, tell us! A wonder, and I say good luck for our passage through the Strait of Malona.
That it is, Captain, a good omen. I'll tell you what I saw.
I have seen no mermaid on our voyage. I have seen no great fish swimming alongside us. No magical creature rests while we're at anchor.
Describe what you saw, Donatello.
It rests at the bottom in the sunlight. The mantle is spread wide on the sand like a pink petticoat. Its shell, a bubble. When I swam up to it, all of its pink flesh miraculously went inside the shell. Shy. But such a large mollusk I have never seen.
She is a gorgeous mollusk. I can taste this pink flesh.
She is not a she, and he is not a he. But I agree. Unusual and beautiful.
Tell Felipe de Gasca de Ortega how it sings. It sang in my dreams last night. I thought I would fall in love.
Even this last night I heard it singing. Like a bubble popping. The air bubbles laughing as they rise through the water. It stood on its shell. A shell that looks like Scottish plaid, and it curtsied.
This mollusk curtsied! See, Felipe de Gasca de Ortega!
Captain Francis, I wanted to cry, it was so beautiful. But I was holding my breath.
And then,
I thought it beckoned me. So I swam away for fear I would be devoured by the pink flesh.
I would not swim away, I would go to it. It's the same singing I heard last night at anchor trying to fall asleep, following us in the form of a mermaid. A Serena. I have goosebumps, feel them.
I did not hear it.
But you did see it run through the waves as we cruised. Yesterday, I pointed and you remarked. You saw it, sir, like an Asian carp jumping to starboard. But this godfish, this god of love and pleasure that camps in a shell and sings keeps me awake. It beckons me, calls to my true self. Turn over a new leaf, it sings. Be less cruel, be kind, and love only.
How could you turn over a new leaf, Captain?
A dream within a dream within a dream, aided by the last of the rum.
3 days and we shall have rum again, when we reach Cuba and take these slaves to the plantation of Manzanillo.
Manzanillo, a fair port. I have a cousin there.
You are excused, Donatello.
I want me one of those.
You know, I hear you, but remember, my man, my woman.
I will get me a whore when we get to
Manzanillo.
Manzanillo, just as you describe your mollusk.
Shut up, sailor.
We don't want to hear your business. Ladies, we are.
Oh, now, delicate sensibilities.
You see my laughing shell, my man-sized mollusk? Send her to me. How pretty. I want to see this for myself. Negrita, I told you, Mary did not toil more than 8 hours. This is the modern way. Soon in Puerto Rico, they would make this law. Soon it would be law. 8 hours only with a break in fresh water. I mean, and she should stay out of the sun. I will be a governor someday, and I will have this great
girl. I cannot ruin her with my old slave habits, and you cannot with your rat-infested sails. I harden her with my wisdom and soften her with my song.
I wish and pray that you could improve her, but your breeding is as a slave. A free slave for now. But Mary is special. She's white. A pearl among pirate swine.
I remind you, Commander, that I purchased my freedom. I am your ally. God would smile on this union, methinks. If you do not summon her flowers, she may yet agree.
Hush, woman, stay out of this. These Europeans are a caste of their own.
I know, Felipe de Gasca de Ortega.
Cast and fire. An internal sun burns and browns, blackens and browns us from within. These ones are conch flesh. And pardon me, Captain Francis and young Mary, as soft as lizards under a rock. Even you, ruddy captain, you fat English fish eater, make her load light. Sing your warm molasses. Let her rest. Do not rattle and prattle her nerves as we lie.
Oh! Men are bums! Asses!
They are weaklings, like babies. I'm no soft lizard. I choose to work, knaves. Huh. That's what I agreed to when I signed this contract. Swine. Filthy pigs. I would rather be a low person of rank on this ship with you, Sylvie.
And while we work, I shall sing. There is nothing better for the soul than work and song.
I will debark in Cuba and find a beautiful mulatto.
Whore. You know, I'd rather suck my pipe than carouse.
What pipe?
Look, the tobacco.
You weren't too old, Mac, to suck anything.
This man shall get a beautiful mulatto whore.
Mm-hmm. Shut up.
Yes, shut up, you.
Well, fine good morning to you as well. The English man of war has just emerged. Please inform the crew that we shall immediately set all but the topsails on my command. When I reach the channel, we'll set all the topsails to catch the wind. We should not have to tack until late in the afternoon. For now, of course, 190 degrees south-southwest.
190 degrees south-southwest!
Tonight and every night between here and Cuba, we sail in the shallows. We won't get caught on the shipping lane, and this may increase the distance between us if they have to anchor.
Best ships they have, but stupid English, they abolish slavery and the price goes sky high. Good for us, bad for them.
If we can stay away from the rocks and the sandbanks and the Strait of Mona, we will make our delivery. Then provision and sail back to steal more of these handy Negroes. I like this way. Steal them already broken in, named Jones and Jeremiah, versed in the lash and in agriculture. A few months from now, we'll be back with another load.
Now I see three masts, and they're setting their mainsails. Must be done with their horn and Mayagüez.
Poor Mayagüez. In 3 days, Manzanillo. There we will get our 5,000 gold pesos and some candy.
Candy for everyone, for the whites, for the mulattoes, for the free colors, even for the slaves, unless they rebel. Every country except Japan has outlawed it, so the price is extraordinarily high. Traders and robbers and middlemen like us swim in gold.
Speed and cunning. We must use our sail day and night, fair weather and foul. Ring the bell.
Ring the bell! If you see a rock or a reef, call out, we shall stay clear. Mind the sandbanks, even though we're at or near high tide. You are on duty until seven bells. And if we run aground, ladies, we all hang at the hands of the English.
Or the Spanish.
Or the Americans, now that slavery's outlawed.
Or the French.
Just don't fall asleep.
The currents are treacherous.
You keep your eyes wide open, Mary. I will keep you company, but...
I cannot stay awake without you, Sylvia. You must not fall asleep.
Wake me and I will relieve you. Oh, how delicious. Oh, Mary.
Oh. Sylvia, try this. If you touch the top of your mouth with your tongue, it tickles and it will help you stay awake. Try that.
See? Oh!
It works.
Oh. You're not going to let me sleep.
No.
Oh. Look at Felipe de Yesterday, Ortega. An iron lamppost standing always there. I love him. But he has promised to join me in Matanzas after the next cargo. You never loved a man? Never?
Yes, when I was a girl in Bermuda.
Who was he?
He was no older than me. 17.
What about him?
Nothing, Sylvia. By tiny devils. I was feverish. It was the grip. And he was kind and wonderful. And then he went to live with his family in North Carolina, and I cut my wrists because living without him was not bearable. Do you want to know anything else? Because there is nothing else.
No. I see why you cannot love the captain.
It is no comparison. The captain is a cruel man. I can barely be on deck with him.
You are a brave woman, Mary. Almost as brave as I am.
Oh,
Sylvia. Sylvia.
What?
Tell me a story. Tell me a story about the plantation.
About what?
Your life. Your life on the plantation.
Oh. I worked in the hothouse where they processed the cane. You'll need to go to hell if you work there. I worked there for many years. I have wiped that from my memory.
Was it really hot inside and noisy? It must have been.
My mother purchased my freedom with the help of my father, a white man who made the final payments to the planter. He took me to Matanzas to live, but not my mother. He was already married to a white woman. Strange, in Matanzas, my own house slave.
A slave? Of your own?
Oh, of course. There I worked to help my... There I worked to help buy my brother's freedom. I'm still saving.
Tell me about your brother. Mulatto also?
Beautiful singing voice. I haven't seen him since I left.
When did you leave the plantation?
I was 14. My brother was 16. He's darker than I am, so it will be hard for him. Danilo.
I have one brother, Charles. I've never seen him. He's in the Navy. He's the spitting image of my grandfather, whose portrait hangs in the library, framed in gold.
Oh, tell me about the portrait on the wall of your grandfather, framed in gold. Tell me about the candelabras. Tell me about the rooms. Oh, did you have pastry for breakfast? My contract is up with the ship when we reach Cuba. I want every detail to keep in my poor brain.
I do not like having those memories. I'm a sailor now, of low rank, and that's how I wish it to be.
Oh, please.
Okay. If I tell you about my house, what will you give me in return?
I will sing.
Yes, yes, I was going to say, sing. There's a long table in the dining room with 8 French high back chairs. And in the hideaway against the wall are silver napkin holders with gems inlaid, good linen napkins, and beautiful macrame tablecloths. On top, there are 3 silver candelabras. On another wall is a fireplace with irons and brass bellows embossed with lions, our coat of arms. My great-grandfather's portrait hangs right next to his brother's in the hallway. Both of them were murdered by the Catholics in Rochelle, France. Our family fled to Bermuda. My grandfather fashioned the first postage stamp. My great-grandfather had been a jeweler in France. Like I said, my mother was a minor English aristocrat. I can play piano, even though I don't have a musical bone in my body. Did you hear me? I have a piano. We have a large house with many windows looking out to the sea. I can barely keep my eyes open. Damn this watch.
But it must be light to have glass in the windows while the sea rages outside. Mary, let me stay in Cuba. Things are changing. It is rumored that the coffee and sugar growers are resisting independence, but independence is near. Blacks and mulattoes are planning together. They are joining with the white insurgents. Blacks and whites, we predict, will throw out Europe's oldest empire. did not hear a word of that, did you, Mary? Cuba will be independent. And I will not leave her again.
Joker's they are.
I bet you love them.
They are like my little brothers.
Not like my brothers. They're not cute.
Donatello, what do you know of Mary's friend?
She left before sunrise, my cousin's boat.
Ah, oh, how marvelous! Already up and out! Already out on the water!
Yes, they're taking him and the other tourists to Chango Reef to snorkel. The water is calm in the morning.
Oh, I'd rather walk on the beach. I'm scared of fish.
Chango, isn't that near Playa Azul? That's 100 miles.
Especially the manta ray and the pepperfish man.
The stingray will jump into a boat and sting you.
Marcella?
Yes, ma'am?
Have you ever been to the United States? My maid, very small, very lovely Portuguese woman, is very ill. She has cancer. She's a wonderful cook. Can you cook, Marcella?
I'm not a very good cook, ma'am.
Mexicans are wonderful cooks.
I can make tortilla.
And beans?
It depends on the price.
I can pay you for cooking as well as cleaning.
Oh, no, ma'am. I mean, how much is a kilo of beans? The market.
Do you make a mole sauce?
Yes, I can make mole. I have all the rooms to clean. Right alone.
What else can you make?
Tortilla con papa, tortilla con colorina, bañadas, tamales.
Oh, wonderful. What do you say?
I cannot leave my family now. I have responsibilities.
Do you live on the mainland?
I go on weekends.
Where is it?
Donde es?
Tell me about Chichimilpa.
There is a church.
And?
Snakes. It is hot.
Do you have TV?
No.
What do you do?
The children play soccer. With the scorpions. There is much work to do at home. We stay out of the sun. Pardon.
Why do you want to know about Rosetta?
I only wanted to know if she would come and work for me.
After your newspaper.
No, at my apartment.
Poor Mary, lonely Mary. No one to help you with your children. No one to help Marcella, too, I suspect. You are a brave woman, Mary. Working, divorced, in danger all the time.
That's me. What other woman do you know who will go in a meeting with mobsters and politicians, alone?
But what do you know
with the whole family at risk?
But why do you go to these meetings, Mary?
Oh, I know.
Follow the money.
And to read between the lines, I tell young journalists like David that what's on the surface is really just covering what's underneath.
Hi, that boy David. Kind of crazy. Enjoying the coral now. But why do you put your own family in danger?
Do you know that David, as young as he is, has read the entire Warren Commission report on the Kennedy assassination? 900 pages. Obsessive, but he is not crazy.
I think he is.
No. There was a poll taken last year, Sylvia. 1967, listen to this. 65% of Americans think that there was more than one shooter. More than one assassin in Dallas. Do you know why? Because we still have the free press. Relatively.
Calm down, Mary.
Do you know what that means if there was another shooter? A cover-up. I'm a journalist. I investigate. For 5 years, I've been sticking my neck out, using sources that no one else dared to use. And I'm still being published. Do you know the name of my column, Sophia? Running Scared. Do you know I have a weekly column?
Play this one.
Oh,
Well, Bobby is dead. Curtains. Finito.
Yes.
I'm sorry. I'm rude.
Bobby. Bobby. David was right. He was going to stop the war. That's why they killed him. He won California. He won California. And Dr. King, shot and killed in April. He spoke out against the war last year and people could not believe that he was brave enough to do that. And now he's been murdered. What a year.
They bumped him off, dirty rats. They, I don't know who.
What a year, Sylvia.
You have a penchant for drama, don't you, Mary? Always looking for dark things on a sunny island. I'm sure you're a very good writer, though. But you're not going to write a story about me, are you?
I get scared. I can't sleep. I'm taking too much Valium. They slashed my tires a few weeks ago, I told you. They call my house when my children come home from school. I'm a bad mother. I'm going to get to the bottom of this story and blow it open.
What story, Mary? You want to interview the captain? That is a story for your newspaper? Your David is so interested in the captain, putting on lipstick, crazy boy. I'm telling you this because I know the difference between a businessman and a crook. The captain is rich, but there is nothing special about the captain. That is the only story about the captain. I am telling you, he is nothing, nothing to worry about. Poof! Just a lot of money. And handsome, still young, and with a whole new face, Mary, you will see.
Listen to me. The man in the bandage is the one you call captain. He is an associate of Big Ears, Charlie Maggiore. Maggiore is a major player on the East Coast. He is a known bookmaker. He doesn't bet on horses, he bets on elections. Political elections. Another associate of his, for your information, is Manny the Horse Ianello. He stings the gay bars. Extortion! He works with the cops. He's part of the witness protection program.
Pizza pie, I am mucho mozzarella italiano.
And this is your captain, but who cares, right?
You don't know about sweet and spicy. Caramel, mela. You don't know nothing about music. You're not going to interview me. You don't know nothing. You know nothing about. You don't know nothing! Nothing about Cuba, or love, or a hot, sexy, spicy cha cha cha! You are lonely, Mary.
The man you call Captain.
Poor Captain. Poor Captain. Like you, he is divorced. His pain is a scar on the sunrise.
Divorce is nothing. It's just pain. I have real dirt on this man. That's why I came.
Tell me about the snow on Fifth Avenue.
Danger. Don't let go.
Danger. But it will be all right. Don't be scared.
But I am scared, Sylvia.
Come on.
Thank you.
This is a game. I lived in Cuba, between acts, from the best card players in the world. I deal 7 cards. All down, except the last. This is a child's game. There's no skill involved. But it's fun. It's a drinking game and a betting game. Have you never played it that way? No.
Why do we have to? It's boring.
Because.
And when are you taking your walk?
I do not walk alone. I'm waiting for Felipe.
Look who I found.
They gave this to us on the beach. I think it belongs to her friend.
Coffee for the captain. Coffee for everyone. It's still hot.
Not for me.
I'll have coffee.
We've had coffee, lots of coffee. It's time for our walk. If one is through, you can come back and rehearse that scene.
Yes, a nice fresh walk. I see the breeze is up.
A new game.
You see, she thought this was a child's game. Too simple. But you see, she cannot figure it out. You two have met?
Yes.
We talked at the bar. About the stock market. Today I'd like to know more about it, I think.
And this island. You talked about Mexico. You have a baby crocodile.
And you have a perfect memory.
Mary is divorced. I'm sorry. Well, everyone is divorced these days. You too, Captain. You are divorced, yes?
Only in America.
I think she is right.
In France, they stay together. Men have mistresses.
I think that too is correct.
What happened to you? Did you have an operation?
While Mary is suffering from a divorce, she also suffers from an assassination.
Oh, I do not.
I too am suffering.
The captain suffers from an assassination too.
Oh, no.
And a divorce.
Well, yes, a divorce, some time ago. Lola's camera.
Lola? He called himself, she, Lola.
Mary, in your case, who is the assassin? The assassin. Who is the assassin?
Do you mean the assassin of the president? Do you mean who killed the president?
Presidents don't matter in the scheme of things, although I do invest in them. Flowers, orchids. Orchids matter more. Flowers. My interest is mostly flowers.
I think you may be right, Captain. Do you grow orchids? I've heard it's not easy.
No, I invest. A much larger share in roses than orchids, but I have many investments. Wine, entertainment.
Many, yes. Golf, dolphins, hotels, and resorts. He owns this one.
Sunshine. You are a reporter. I invest also in television and in newspapers.
Let's not talk business. I'm an American on a divorce vacation.
He is American too.